I just happen to have this random shoe here. While I was in university, a professor asked the class, how many people do you think it takes to buy a pair of shoes? The immediate obvious answer is, well, it's me and the salesperson, right? Actually, when you start to think about it, there's way more people involved, and you start to get an idea of just how big a supply chain can become, and that's just a simple tennis shoe. You can certainly draw parallels from a traditional like manufacturing type of supply chain to a software supply chain. A vendor could no longer be available. A pandemic may happen, and you have to figure out how to work around that. Even if you don't use software directly, which I think is very difficult to do these days, you're most likely interacting with people that are. You go to a grocery store, point of sale systems. Your vehicle most likely is running some sort of software today. A software supply chain attack is someone with not so great intentions trying to breach, disrupt, or infiltrate a supply chain as a vehicle to get to something else. A major disruption to those supply chains could be impactful to anyone that depends on them. We have to recognize that attacks on the software supply chain will likely grow more frequent, which can be daunting, but we should not panic. We can liken the software supply chain to how we get our drinking water. Of course, anyone is free to go to a lake or river and retrieve their own water, but then they inherit all the responsibilities, transporting it, making sure that it's safe to use. With an open source model, it's similar. Customers could go upstream and retrieve the software themselves, but then there are similar responsibilities. They need to make sure that there's a proper chain of custody, that they're testing it, they're ensuring that it's secure. Either way, you want reassurances that what's in that source can be trusted. A company can have a very secure supply chain, but it's only going to be as strong as the weakest link. So if somewhere upstream or downstream from them is vulnerable, then they are too. With open source software, you gain the benefits of transparency, things like CVEs and bug bounties. But this doesn't eliminate the need for multiple security controls and layers of defense. Any good security program, whether it's information security or supply chain security, is going to have a clear and concise plan that involves people, process, and technology. You have to plan for the eventuality that some sort of an incident is going to occur. How do you minimize the disruption, mitigate it in other ways, whether it's NIST or SSDF or SALSA? It's not just necessarily going the extra mile, it's just being a responsible part of the software community, I think.